So thank you very much. I truly appreciate this particular invitation from Fairtrade Africa during this Global Youth Convention, which is of the first of its kind and the flagship, of course. And I wish to share with you an overview on youth governance. My name is Hilda Ojall, formerly the IC Africa Youth Network President and currently the Women Representative to the Board of International Cooperative Alliance. So I wish to first share with you the current reality of youth engagement. The truth is that young people have not been encouraged to be in, or rather to take up leadership roles for one reason or the other. Sometimes we are told that no, we are still too young to lead, and we need to step aside for those who are older or much elderly so that they can take up those roles. And this quite makes us get discouraged from time to time. So you will find that young people are not taking up those roles. And we have an aging, we find more of aging boards within the cooperative movement and not younger looking persons. So having said that, I think it is important that we engage young people so that we can pass on the knowledge, we can pass on the values and the principles that we hold dearly about the cooperative movement. I would like to share with you why would we engage youth in leadership, really? And I think it is important for us to engage young people in leadership roles because they're able to develop their leadership skills and be able to take responsibility within the cooperative sector and even beyond. And in the event that they also wish to, you know, have their own enterprises, maybe cooperative-led, then they're able to get the knowledge that they acquired when they were in leadership, and also the resources and improve access to market and productive resources. And another thing is that when you engage young people in leadership, they will have the opportunity to develop social consciousness, which goes with principle number 6, which is the concern for community. Because cooperatives are more of social enterprises and they believe in reaching out to the community or even to the societies at large. And also through the leadership, young people are able to have democratic governance. Cooperatives will expose these young members to democratic values and culture, and that will help them also build their confidence to take leadership roles and be able to, take these roles in various contexts. And as I said, even beyond the cooperative movement. It is important for these young people to be engaged in leadership because you will find that if you lack representation of young people, then you will not be able to know what these young people within your cooperative want. And you'll find that they will go to a more, vibrant, more youthful cooperative, which definitely no cooperative would love to lose members because that is their source of income. It is their source of pride and all that. And I think once you engage young people in leadership roles, definitely there'll be questions that are coming up. there'll be a lot of curiosity at that point, and this will yield into intergenerational dialogue, whereby we want to learn more as young people. We want to engage more and get more understanding of what is happening at the governance level, so that we are able to look for more innovative ideas, so that we are able to reach out even to young people and even change their perception on cooperatives and be able to woo them into our cooperatives, because it is more, you know, tech savvy, it is more vibrant, it is more friendly in terms of taking up loans and even ensuring that I get the best interest rate as a young person. So these young people are the ones who are going to get their friends, because not many youth are engaged in cooperatives, but we need more youth in cooperatives, and they're out here. So it is only through getting these young people at the governance level, at the leadership level, so that they can be able to reach out to more youth and bring more people within the cooperative movement. I wish to share with you as a young person, because I do not only give talks, but we go to the ground to, you know, make a change as young people within the ICA Africa Youth Network. So with this on your screen, we had the Go Green campaign, which was an interregional campaign promoting SDG 13. And we thought that it would be important for us to plant trees across the globe to mark the Cooperative Day, and also embrace our concern for community by planting trees, and also educating our societies and our communities about our concern for environment. So you can see from the picture, we did the Go Green campaign from Kenya, Botswana, South Africa. We had a team from the Kingdom of Eswatini, and also we had members from Ivory Coast, Tanzania, and Egypt coming in to participate during the Go Green campaign. We had the Global Cooperative Enterprise Program, Entrepreneurship Program, which is a mentoring program, and it is framed within the ICA-EU partnership. This program has really assisted us in ensuring that young people create cooperative enterprises within the cooperative business model, so that they are able to engage more young people and create jobs for other young people. We have we did the Global Cooperative Entrepreneurship Program in two countries, that is in Uganda and Zimbabwe. And we did have three ambassadors from each country. And as you can see, we have two registered cooperatives that are currently running. The four remaining cooperatives are running, but they have not been registered. So we are still at the paperwork stage. It is important for me to say that we already have membership within those different cooperatives. And from Uganda, we have about 145 members. And from Zimbabwe, we have about 80 members and still growing. As you can see, these are mentors and ambassadors being taught. We have registration certificates down below, and we have one of our members who is differently abled and is able to still lead the rest of her team in terms of agriculture cooperative. We did have the replication project, And this project was actually funded by one of our members, Dejardin. That was also through the ICA Youth Network globally. And we had two members of the ICA Africa Youth Network win this replication project of 10,000 euros each. And they were able to start their cooperative and engage more youthful members so that they grow their cooperative and also give an opportunity to other young people to serve their cooperative. And they are doing quite well. They have made a lot of impact within their societies in terms of creation of job, in terms of having organic food cropping system, and they are doing quite well. We also have school cooperatives that we are looking into, and this is just to assist in school students to be able to develop knowledge on personal finance, regardless of the level of income, of course, and also to instill the culture of savings among school-going children or youth through the use of savings cooperatives. So this is just a model that is being used by 40 school cooperatives, and they're working together with Junior Achievement Swaziland. Junior Achievement is one of our members we are in partnership with, and a local cooperative which is able to safeguard the monies of the school-going children. As the youth network, we've also been able to have two global youth forums, that is in 2020 and 2021. And it is quite interesting that we've gotten a chance as also Fairtrade Africa to have a virtual global youth convention. This is just to be able to expose different young people across the globe to be able to introduce them to other sectors of the cooperatives, because it is not only savings and credits cooperatives. We have transport cooperatives, and we have experts who can actually talk about the transport cooperatives. We have experts who can talk about agricultural cooperatives. And this is actually the right forum that we had in 2020 and this year, that we engaged young people to come and ask questions, to come and learn, to come and share and benchmark with the rest of the members across the globe. So we have been doing a lot. This is just but a few that I have mentioned. But at the same time, I wish to make a call to the different stakeholders present to be able to support young people, especially when they are vying or when they want to vie for leadership positions within different levels of leadership. It is important that these young people are supported, because they are the now, they are the future. And if you do not want to work with the youth, definitely, then the organization that you work for will not be there for long. That is for sure, because we know that 60% of Africa is made of youth. Over 65% of the globe is made of youth. So we are the majority. We can be able to dissect our issues. We can be able to find solutions for our organizations which affect young people. And it is important that you come and assist us where we may run short of knowledge and be able to help us. So So this is just a call also to the young people that, you know, leadership is not about being given leadership on a silver platter. It is for us to show that we are capable. Once we have been given the leadership role, we are capable of steering what we have been given. And leadership is more about being a servant rather than being a boss. So thank you very much for this opportunity that you have accorded me to speak to you during this forum. I truly appreciate and have a fruitful discussion. Thank you.